We will give a background color for our table and then we will see how we can insert the chart. So we will select the table and then here we have the background color, and from here we will select a light shade. So we can give a background color like this. We can give a background color for your table if you need. And now we are going to insert the chart. So I want to get a chart regarding the vegetables and the total production of each vegetable. So I am selecting the names of the vegetables and then we want to select the column, the total. So press the control key and then select the total. If you are not pressing the control key, you will not be able to select the total, your the first, the names of the vegetables will go, the selection will go. So if two columns or two rows are not near, you have to select like this. And then to insert the chart, we have the insert chart icon. I am selecting that. And then, and now I got the chart wizard window. And here we have the different types of charts that we can create. We are concerned only with the first three types: column, bar, and then pie. Column chart and bar chart are almost similar. Only thing is the position of the chart will differ. So we will select column first, and then we want to give the give a name for this chart. And then this is the x-axis where you can see the names of the vegetables, and here you have the values regarding the production, and this is your y-axis. So we want to give a name for the chart, and then we want to give a x-axis title and then a y-axis title for the y-axis. So after selecting the chart type, we have to click the next button thrice. 1, 2, and 3. After clicking the next button thrice, we will get this window where you can enter the chart title and all. Title, here I am giving vegetables versus production. Vegetables versus production as a title for the chart. So here we got that. I am not giving the subtitle. If you want, you can give a subtitle. And then x-axis, I am giving the title as names of the vegetables. Names of the vegetables. And y-axis, I am typing production. And then I am selecting the finish button. So here I got that chart, and you can see one gray border for this chart, and that means your chart has been selected. And when you bring the mouse pointer here, you will get this hand symbol, and you can click and drag and keep this down if you want. And here, suppose you want to make this chart bigger, the size bigger or smaller, when you bring the mouse pointer, near the corner you will get this arrow and then you click and drag so that you can either increase or decrease the size of the chart. We are going to see how we can give border for the chart. And here, as I told you, and suppose we are not having this gray border, your chart is like this, and how will you get that border? You have to double click inside this chart twice and you will get that border. And then we want to give a border for this chart, so right click, format chart area, and here the first tab itself is border, and by default the we are not having any border. We will select the first one, and here it is black. We'll change that to say dark blue. And then if you want, you can change the width. It is 0.2 centimeter, and then OK. So here we got one, the border for this chart. And now we will see how we can fill color. So first of all, we will fill color inside this chart area. So I am bringing the mouse pointer here, again right click, then format wall. From here, again if you want one border, you can select and you can change the width and you can give the color. And then I'm giving, I want to fill a color, a single color you can select from here. And if it is double shade, we can select from gradient. See here, I am selecting a double color, one light shade. And here, if it is bitmap, I can select from here, pattern from here, and hatch from here. So here I need a gradient, one double shade only I need, then OK. I think you are not able to see that. We'll select another color. And here it is already blue color, so now you might be able to see, isn't it? So we have filled one color here, and here I want to fill another color, this. So you bring the mouse pointer here, again right click and select format chart area. And here from area, I am selecting bitmap. And I am going to fill with this. So like this, I gave this because you want to see the difference, isn't it? So that is why I gave this. Otherwise, we'll give another light shade. from Power Man chart area. So like this, you can format your chart. And now we will see how we can insert a pie chart. So to insert a pie chart, so I'll drag and keep this. To drag, you have to click on this line and then you drag. And now I want the measure of land used and the name of the owner of that land. So I am selecting these two columns, and since these two columns are adjacent, I can select these the column D and E together, and I can select the values. And now to insert the chart, again from insert chart I am selecting the chart type as pie, and here we have different types of the pie chart. I am selecting the first one, and since this pie chart is not having the x and the y axis, we are not able to give the title for the x and the y, but we can give the title for the chart. So next, again three times you have to click next, and then title. I'm giving the title as owner versus land. You can give some other title also, and then finish. So this also we will drag and keep this down, and here you have the numbers, and that indicates the persons. Here we have the format data series. And if we want, here also we can give the colors and all. Format area. Here we gave a light shade. So like this, you can insert the chart related to your the columns that you need. And with this, your sixth chapter is over, and before leaving we will save this. So to save this, to save this from file, we have to select. We have already saved this once, isn't it? So so we will give Control S and save. Control S. Otherwise, if we are saving for the first time, then from file, save as, and then we will give the name as say chapter 6. and then you have to select the folder, your folder students underscore works underscore 8, and you select your folder, double click and open that, and you create the folder, say calc, then enter, and then we will save this here. So like this you have to save, and with this your sixth chapter is over. Thank you.